Hello, my name's David, and in this video we're going to take a look at converting this stock image into a rather nice arty comic book effect. We're going to start by cropping off the bottom of the image. Try pressing C on the keyboard, or you can come up to the toolbox and pick up the crop tool. It's coming to the center grab handle at the bottom. We're going to click down. I'm going to lift it up. We're going to take it to this sort of area here, which is almost a square format. Double click anywhere inside the framework will apply the crop. Now the next thing we're going to do is we're going to create a sketch effect. So with the background layer, make sure it's highlighted. Now I'm going to use Command J or Control J. That's Command J, Control J to duplicate it. We're now going to head up to an adjustment layer. So it's layer, down to new adjustment layer. We're going to come across to HSL. That's hue, saturation, luminance. Make sure you select the end one. Now this is for all colors, so that is important. Make sure you select this one. Now head down to saturation shift, taking it all the way to the left hand side. So we've now got a black and white image, which is at -100%. Click to close it down, and we're going to click on the layer immediately underneath the adjustment layer. We're now going to invert it. In other words, we're going to change it into a black and white negative. Very simple to do. Press, hold down, Command or Control. Holding down Command or Control, now press the letter I on the keyboard, and there it is, there's our black and white negative. Next, we're going to head up to a blend mode. We're going to change it from normal. We're going to go down to color dodge. Now, depending on the image you're working on, you may have it just plain white. Other images, you'll see a few black lines. This one, there's a fair bit there, but either way, don't worry. Now head up to layer, come down to new live filter layer, blur, Gaussian blur, but it's also worth trying any of these blur filters. They can all make a really good sketch effect. But going for Gaussian blur, let's lift it up. Let's zoom in, which is Command or Control. Press hold down Command or Control. Now press plus on the keyboard. Disappeared, not gonna worry. Gonna just move it across. And as we start to move it over, you can see the sketch effect starting to come through. We're at 0.5, taking it up higher. Let's go to 1 pixel, 1.4. That looks really good. Over the top there, at back there, like that one, 2.2. I think we'll use that. Clicking on the little cross to accept. Heading up to the top layer, which is this one here. I'm now going to right click. We're going to go down to Merge Visible. In other words, we're going to merge all these layers into one visible layer. And just waiting for it to go across. There it is there. There's our new pixel layer showing our sketch. We can now click on this one. We can press shift on the keyboard. We can click on our Gaussian blur. They are all highlighted. Try using Command G, Control G to put it into a new group. Now it's entirely up to you. At this stage you can delete it, or you can click on it, drag it, place it underneath the background layer, switch it off, and just keep it just in case you want to come back to it and make adjustments. Right, clicking on our background layer, I'm going to switch off our sketch layer. We're going to zoom out to fit on screen, which is Command 0 or Control 0. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to make a selection to remove her from the background. Up to the toolbox, we're going to pick up the selection brush tool, which is W is the shortcut. Now the brush I'm using is 227 pixels in size, and I'm using Snap to Edge. Coming over the shoulder, just round here, round the hair, coming quickly up and around here, just bringing in all these bits and pieces down over the glasses like this, just making sure we got that as well. Round this area of the head, hand, wrist, arm. Down we go, over the chair as well, just bringing it round like that. Looks pretty good. Okay, next, we're going to head up to Refine. Just going to lift this up, and I'm using a preview of Overlay. Right, there's the size of the brush I'm using. You can use the left and the right-hand square brackets to make the brush bigger or smaller. You can see the brush size down the bottom. Now I'm going to bring it into this area. What I like to do, because we've got quite a few sort of stray hairs, I want to make sure I try and get all of them. So I'm going to click, I'm going to keep the brush so it's just on the hair as well, on the head, coming around, trying to get those stray hairs in, just keeping it on the edge. Basically what we're doing is we're saying this is the color I want to keep. and I want to remove all the other, which is the white color. So making sure we get those bits in as well. Just waiting for it to work. There it is, the refined selection. Round it goes, just to make sure. I'm just gonna quickly back comb. Not quite sure that's the right expression for it, but round we go. That will do nicely. Okay, now we've done that, I'm going to come quickly over the hand like that there, because I just had a funny feeling. I don't think we had all of it in. Over the area of the glasses, over the hair here, coming down around there, coming down onto the arm and the hair as well. Making sure we get all those little bits and pieces in, which we just have. Over the hair and round up over here, and that little bit there will do nicely. Okay, just waiting for that to work. Now I'm not going to touch smooth, feather, nor ramp. I'm going to come down to output selection. We're going to change to new layer. Why haven't I used smooth, feather, or ramp? Because we got some very fine hairs. If I'd used any of those, we would have removed those fine little wispy hairs. Okay, you're thinking, what fine little wispy hairs? Well, let's just click on the background. Let's add a new background to our image. So we're going to pick up the rectangle tool. U is the shortcut. Fill, I think, with this image. Let's see, I think, yeah, a nice sort of light blue color would work. Treat with the coloring and just bringing it here, dragging it over. Yes, you can see those fine wispy hairs have just come through, and down around this area, it does a remarkable job. Great stuff. Look at those hairs. Stroke. Yeah, I've got a bit of an idea. Let's click on this. Let's go for white. Right, there's our stroke. Well, you can't see it. It's 0.2 points in size. That's why you can't see it. If I move it across, it'll suddenly burst into life. There it is, taking it right the way over. Yeah, let's come into the image. Let's go for the maximum. Great stuff. That looks good. Notice I've got a bit missing, so bringing that over as well. So there's our little bits of wispy hair. The stroke border going behind our model. Great, that'll do nicely. Okay, now for that arty sort of cartoony effect, we're going to click on this layer here. We're now going to head up to layer. We're going to come down to new adjustment layer, and we're going to come down to posterize. On posterize, the default is 4 points. Now you can, or 4 pixels, well, for whatever it happens to stand for. Try the others, 2, taking up to 3, 5, that looks pretty good. 6, nope. And there's more you put in, nope. I'm going to drop it back, 5. That's the one I quite like. Let's leave it like that for now. Don't forget, we are using adjustment layers. We can come back, we can make adjustments. Right, the next filter we're going to use is, again, we're going to go to layer. This time we're going to be using a new live filter layer. We're going to come across to noise. We're going to go to dust and scratches. Now it's going to add it as a child to our posterize. So let's click on it, lifting it up, putting it immediately above. Right, lifting this up as well. Coming to the radius slider, let's move this across, taking it to 11 to 15, looking at the image. I'm now just grabbing hold of the slider. I am moving it, just looking and seeing what it's doing to the image. There, what have we got? We have got 30.4 pixels. That looks really good. Let's accept it by clicking on the cross. Okay, next, let's go back to our sketch layer. Let's switch it on. Let's zoom in a bit. Using Command or Control, now plus on the keyboard, in we zoom. We're going to change the blend mode from normal. Let's go down to darken. Doesn't do much. Multiply, that looks really good. Just trying some of the others. Let's go back up to multiply. Let's come down to this one here, linear burn. Like what that's doing. It's done a lovely job around the eyes there. Pressing the space bar, looking at the hair, that's done a really nice job with that. Let's use Command J, Control J again, just to increase the sketch layer effect. Let's use Command J, Control J again. Yeah, that looks really good. And doing so, we've enhanced that hair even further. Looks really good coming around the wrist as well. Great stuff. That will do nicely. Okay, we're on the top layer. Press and hold down Shift on the keyboard. Coming down to this layer here, click on it. All three are highlighted. Command G, Control G is the shortcut to group them together. Double clicking on group. We're going to call this one what it is, which is our sketch layer. Now something else we're going to do is we're going to add those little spots that you sometimes see on the cartoon effects. So let's head back up to Layer. Coming down to New Live Filter Layer, we're going to come across to Color. We're going to go to Half Tones. Now when this opens, again, it's applied it as a child. I'm going to click, we're going to lift it up, we're going to put it right on the very top. So looking for that blue line, in that goes, changing it from monochrome to color. We're also going to change the blend mode from normal. Let's come down to darken. Let's try that. That looks better. Let's come down and drop the opacity right the way down to blend it in. Coming down even further. Let's just come up a touch or two, 15, 16. Let's leave it like that. Taking the cell size right the way down. Coming down even further. There, that looks pretty good. That's that cartoony effect that I was looking for. Clicking on it, one thing when we're in here, those eyes, they look a little bit on the flat side. So let's put in a new empty layer. This is a new pixel layer. As with everything, double click, give it a name so you know exactly what's on this particular layer. Picking up the paintbrush, press B on the keyboard, making sure you got white as the foreground color. Brushes, I've got the basic brushes. Got a hard brush, I think 16 pixels is the one I selected. 16 pixels it is now. Opacity 100, flow 100, hardness 100, bringing it out. I think I want it to be a little bit bigger, so I'm going to use the right hand square bracket. Let's take it up one notch, just clicking down here. Let's bring in my brush over here, dropping it down one size using the left hand square bracket for that. Clicking down, there it is. There's our little highlights, just to set that off. Using Command or Control, now pressing minus on the keyboard, let's go out. Well, we're going to fit on screen there. That looks pretty good. We can fold this up out of the way, or we can just take a look. Perhaps you might want to reduce, yeah, just taking one of the sketch effects. That's looking a little bit better. Coming down even further, let's go to back to a posterize one here. Let's click to bring this up. I'm going to come to the opacity. I'm going to drop the opacity down. Just taking it to around about the 50, 60. I like this sort of look. That it's this bit here that really does remind me of comics. And yeah, I just like the way that's working on 58%. Let's accept it. You can see the way it's changed it here as well. But that looks really good. Using Command or Control, now plus, let's zoom into this area here. And that looks good. Pressing the spacebar, having a good look around. Like the way this is looking. Save it in layers. Now everything with this is completely adjustable. If you want to go back to square one, you can, because you've still got your basic sketch effect down the bottom. If you don't want it, of course you can delete it. Right, that looks really good. So go on and give it a try. Command 0, Control 0 to go to fit on screen. I'm also going to press the tab on the keyboard to remove all of the panels. Command 0, Control 0 to go to fit on screen. So go on, give it a try. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Give it the thumbs up if you have. Don't forget to subscribe. There's plenty more videos to come. And if you click that little bell icon, you'll receive a notification every time a new video is posted. But until the next time, it is Happy Imaging, and take care.